Hello, everyone. I'm Keisha Williams. I'm an AWS Machine Learning Hero, and I currently serve as the Program Director at Slalom in our AWS Cloud Residency Program. Bias is a huge impediment to fully realizing the benefits of machine learning. And if you've worked with machine learning before, you know that to produce a well-performing model, bias needs to be detected and mitigated very early on in the machine learning lifecycle. So today you'll see the power of Amazon SageMaker Clarify to detect bias throughout the machine learning lifecycle. Our agenda today, first we'll talk about bias. What is it? And then we'll look at Amazon SageMaker to see how it can help you mitigate bias. We'll talk about uncovering bias in your data and detecting bias in your trained model. What is bias? When we think about bias, bias surfaces when a model makes a prediction that is less favorable to a group or an individual, and there's really no relevant difference among the individuals or groups that warrants that prediction. Now, bias can negatively impact people's lives, so it's very important that we get a handle on it. For instance, if you have a machine learning model that you train primarily on data from a younger group of individuals, then that model may be less accurate for middle-aged people or older people. So that's a great example of bias in machine learning. And bias can actually surface throughout the machine learning lifecycle. Bias can be found in your training data. If your data set is imbalanced or if it doesn't accurately represent the environment that the model will be deployed in, that could be bias. Bias also shows itself in the machine learning algorithm. Even with a well-balanced training data set, the outcome might favor certain subsets of the data compared to others. And lastly, bias can actually show up in your trained model because of drift. So once you have a model that's in production, the data changes and the relationships really between your target and your other variables can change over time. And then that degrades the predictive power of your machine learning model. But we have Amazon SageMaker Clarify, and it comes to the rescue. It's a newish feature of Amazon SageMaker that helps you detect bias in your data and in your machine learning model. Now, this is just a quick look at the machine learning lifecycle. If you're familiar with that process, typically you start with your data, preparing your data, processing your data. And when you look at this slide and you see the green, that is where Clarify actually plugs in to the machine learning lifecycle to help you find bias. So if you're preparing your data, you can use Clarify in Data Wrangler. That helps you measure bias in your data. If you're at the point where you're ready to train and tune your model, you can use Clarify in SageMaker Studio. That helps you measure bias in your model. It also helps you explain your model predictions. And then on the far right, once your model is actually in production, you can use Clarify and Model Monitor, and that helps explain your model predictions in real time. And it also helps you monitor your model for drift. When we think about SageMaker Clarify and detecting bias and explaining model predictions, there are really four main areas that we talk about. We have the pre-training bias, the post-training bias, model explainability, and then the model monitor. Today, we're going to look at the two areas in green. So the pre-training bias and the post-training bias. And we'll use Clarify to help identify imbalances in our data set before we train, And then we'll use Clarify to check a trained model. And what's really cool about Clarify is that it produces these PDF reports that describe the biases and the severities. And although we will not discuss explaining model behavior and monitoring the model once in production, Clarify can also help with those areas. In the PDF reports produced by SageMaker Clarify, you'll see various metrics. What's really cool is that out of the box, Clarify comes with 8 pre-training bias metrics and 13 post-training bias metrics. We'll look at a few of those metrics today. For pre-training, we'll look at class imbalance and difference in proportions of labels. And then for post-training, we'll look at the accuracy difference, the difference in acceptance rate, and the recall difference. Another feature of Clarify that I like, you can actually call out to the APIs directly from a Jupyter notebook, and that's what we'll look at today. So for pre-training bias, there is a function called run pre-training bias, and we use that during the data preparation stage. And then there's also a function called run post-training bias, and that's after the model training. So let's actually see this in action. Let's first look at the pre-training bias that will allow us to uncover bias in our data. Just want to give you a quick overview of the model that I trained. It's a public safety model, and it basically predicts if a stop is going to lead to an arrest. So I pulled stop and search data from the UK. The problem type that I'm solving is a binary classification. So it simply answers a yes or no question. Will the stop lead to an arrest? And I use the XGBoost SageMaker's version to train the model. A quick look at the data. There's the outcome that determines whether or not this stop led to an arrest. The additional data points include the date, the latitude and longitude, gender, age range, and ethnicity. So several features like ethnicity and age range and gender, we really care about bias and we want to make sure that we mitigate any bias across those features. For the pre-training bias metrics, this just really helps you understand how your data is distributed, which could, in the end, skew your results. And with pre-training bias, it's really meant to answer one question. Do all of the facet values have equal or similar representation in the data? And what's a facet? It's just a column or a feature in your data set that you want to measure bias for. And when we talk about pre-training, like I mentioned, it's all about imbalances in the data. So here we have this Jupyter notebook. I've already pre-processed the data and formatted it for the machine learning process. So let's just skip down to the Clarify portion, specifically where we're calling out to the pre-training bias code to generate the report. So first, we'll create a SageMaker processing job, and we'll use that to detect the pre-training bias. Now, there are two important configurations that we need to set up. The first is shown here. It's the data config. And this is simply, it points to where the data to analyze can be found in S3, where to put the final report, and what we are predicting, and the type of data set being used. The next configuration option is called the bias config, and this is really the bias detection settings. It defines the favorable outcomes in the label value threshold, and it defines the facets. And remember, again, that's just the sensitive columns that we want to monitor for bias. Once we set up those configurations, we can run the processing job, and we do that using this run pre-training bias function. And we'll pass in the data config and the bias config objects. Now, running this will take several minutes depending on the size of the data and the type and number of processing instances. And after the job is finished, it produces a PDF report. So this is a look at the output of that code that I just showed you. We have this PDF report, and within this report, you'll see the data distribution of the outcome. And the outcome is the value that we're trying to predict. So we see the distribution of the data. If we continue to scroll down, you'll actually see some of the metrics. So the pre-training bias metrics that I spoke to you about. The first that I really want to look at is the class imbalance. Continue to scroll down, we'll see the entire list. So here for class imbalance, this basically shows if we have equal representation across the data set. So a perfectly balanced data set gives a value of 0. But notice here, this value is 0.557. So that means the balance isn't that great. The next important metric is the difference in proportions of labels. Now this measures the distribution of the positive outcomes, in our case, a stop that does not lead to an arrest, and it measures it across the facet values. Here, this value is 0.018. And so the farther this value is from zero, it shows the more that there's a lot of bias in the data. So now let's look at the post-training bias. And this is where you've trained your model and now you want to test that model for bias. The post-training bias metrics and Clarify really help you answer two key questions. Are all of the facet values represented at a similar rate in positive or favorable model predictions? And does the model have similar predictive performance for all the facet values? And with post-training, it really just considers the predictions of the model. So let's see this in action. We go back to our Jupyter notebook. Let's scroll down to the post-training bias section. We'll need to scroll past the actual training of the model, setting up the model hosting, and we get to this post-training bias report. Now you'll need to add an additional configuration called model config, and that's shown right here. This model config, it defines where that trained model is located in S3. It also defines the instance type and the quantity to spin up for the job. Next, if you just scroll down and you take a look at this run post training bias function, that's the function that we're going to run to actually produce the report. So let's take a look at the report. Again, in this post-training bias report, you'll see the distribution of the outcome, so the value that we want to predict. If you continue to scroll down, you'll also see the confusion matrix, which really helps us understand how our model is performing. But let's really scroll down to the post-training bias metrics. We see several metrics. The first one I want to call out is this accuracy difference. Now, this measures the difference between the prediction accuracy for the favored and disfavored facets. So when we look at this value, it's a negative 0.019. Now, a score of 0 means the accuracy for both groups is the same. So larger values indicate larger differences in accuracy. Next, let's take a look at this difference in acceptance rate. Now, this measures the difference in the ratios of the observed positive outcomes to the predicted positives. And the value here is negative 0.018. And lastly, we have the recall difference. This compares the recall of the model for the favored and disfavored facets. So there are several metrics that you can look at, but the three that we showed really shows that some work is needed to mitigate bias before this model is ready to be placed in a production environment. I hope you've realized how easy it is to call out to the SageMaker APIs to help you understand bias in your data and bias in your trained model. So we looked at measuring bias in our data, measuring it in the model. Although we did not have an opportunity to look at explaining the model predictions and monitoring your model for drift, I really encourage you to research more about SageMaker Clarify and play around with those two additional features on your own. Thank you.